tar en runde utenriks og starter i London, der den omstridte utleveringssaken mot Julian Assange ble ferdig i dag.
The truth is, this is journalism on trial. This is the fate and the future of journalism.
Etter 4 uker med bevisføring i Old Bailey er rettssaken nå ferdig. Rett over nyttår får Wikileaks-grunnleggeren Julian Assange svar på om han blir utlevert fra Storbritannia til USA. Assange, som har offentliggjort hemmelige dokumenter om USAs krigføring, risikerer 175 år i fengsel om han utleveres.
He risks his life to promote transparency. Please welcome Julian Assange.
Julian is a publisher. Julian is also a son. He's a friend. He's my fiancé and a father. Our children need their father. Julian needs his freedom. And our democracy needs a free press.
United Nations Special Rapporteur on Torture is warning that WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange is suffering from the effects of psychological torture due to his ongoing detention and threats of possible extradition to the United States. Melzer writes, quote, "In 20 years of work with victims of war, violence, and political persecution, I've never seen a group of democratic states ganging up to deliberately isolate, demonize, and abuse a single individual for such a long time."
Request permission to
WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange has been arbitrarily detained by Sweden and the United Kingdom since his arrest in London on 7 December 2010 as a result of the legal action taken against him by both governments. The expert panel called on the Swedish and British authorities to end Mr. Assange's deprivation of liberty. I think the recommendation is quite clear.
Grunnleggeren av nettstedet WikiLeaks var anmeldt for voldtekt i et døgn.
Siktet for voldtekt og trakassering av to kvinner.
Julian Assange er gått under jorda etter anklager om trakassering fra to kvinner i Sverige.
To kvinner som anmelder Assange for seksuelle overgrep. Ekspressen, fredag i forrige uke. Nyheten går verden rundt. Påtalemakten sikter Assange for voldtekt. Svensk påtalemakt henla denne uken voldtektssaken.
There was not a suspicion of rape.
Men Assange etterforskes fortsatt for upassende fysisk kontakt med en annen voksen. Overgriper eller offer for en svertekampanje.
Og advokaten til de to kvinnene mener at Assange bør siktes for voldtekt.
I Sverige foreligger det arrestordre på mannen for påståtte overgrep og seksuell trakassering.
Etter at han for en uke siden ble etterlyst internasjonalt for voldtekt i Sverige.
Voldtektsanklagen fra Sverige.
Dette er en del av en større svertekampanje, det har de sagt at de mener det er. Og at det kan bety at han blir videre utlevert til USA, dersom etterforskningen av ham i USA fører til en rettsprosess der.
Er det grunn til å tro at fengslingen i London og WikiLeaks-avsløringene henger sammen på noen måte?
Altså det han holdes for her nå er jo den anklagen som er i Sverige, altså at han skal ha voldtatt og seksuelt misbrukt kvinner der.
Sverige vil ha ham utlevert i forbindelse med voldtektsanklager.
Assange er ønsket av svensk påtalemyndighet for avhør i forbindelse med en voldtektsanklage.
Han er mistenkt for seksuelle overgrep mot to kvinner i Sverige.
Etter voldtektsanklagene mot han der.
Seksuelle overgrep.
Assange er mistenkt for seksuelle overgrep mot to svenske kvinner, noe som etter britisk lov er voldtekt.
Han nekter å reise til Sverige for å forklare seg om voldtektsanklager der.
Svenskene krever ham utlevert for å høre hans forklaring på anklagene om voldtekt og seksuelt misbruk.
Seksuelle overgrep.
Mens sekssaken mot han kverner sakte i rettsapparatet, siktet for seksuelle overgrep mot to kvinner.
WikiLeaks grunnlegger Julian Assange kan innen kort tid bli utlevert til Sverige, der han er mistenkt blant annet for voldtekt.
WikiLeaks grunnleggeren er siktet for seksuelle overgrep i Sverige.
Assange skal sendes ut av Storbritannia og til Sverige, hvor han er tiltalt for voldtekt.
I Sverige står han tiltalt for seksuelle overgrep.
Assange er mistenkt for å ha begått seksuelle overgrep i Sverige.
Men også fordi to kvinner i Sverige har anklaget ham for å ha forsøkt voldta dem.
Assange har oppholdt seg 2 år i Ecuadors ambassade i London for å unngå å bli utlevert til Sverige, der han er anklaget for seksuelle overgrep.
I tillegg vil han unngå utlevering til Sverige etter anklager om seksuelle overgrep mot to kvinner.
På grunn av de beskyldningene om seksuelle overgrep.
WikiLeaks grunnleggeren har sittet i politisk asyl i den ekvadorianske ambassaden i Storbritannia i snart 3 år. Assange er siktet for seksuelle overgrep mot to kvinner.
Han er anklaget for seksuelle overgrep mot to svenske kvinner.
Sett ham fri. FN mener Julian Assange er ulovlig frihetsberøvet, men uvisst om han kan forlate oppholdsstedet.
Det er uklart hva som skjer med Julian Assange, selv om FN mener han bør settes fri. I 2010 anklages han for voldtekt og seksuelle overgrep i Sverige. Assange nekter for dette, men melder seg for britisk politi. Og i dag kom FN med sin konklusjon. Julian Assange bør settes fri.
WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange has been arbitrarily detained by Sweden and the United Kingdom since his arrest in London on 7 December 2010 as a result of the legal action taken against him by both governments. The expert panel called on the Swedish and British authorities to end Mr. Assange's deprivation of liberty. I think the recommendation is quite clear.
This
is a victory that cannot be denied.
Ja, har denne konklusjonen fra FN i det hele tatt noen betydning?
De har bare konkludert, og kanskje ikke konkludert så klart heller.
I think the recommendation is quite clear. Respect his physical integrity and freedom of movement, and afford him the right to compensation.
Han blir anklaget for seksuelle overgrep mot to svenske kvinner.
I 2010 ble han etterlyst av svensk påtalemyndighet, anklaget for seksuelle overgrep mot to svenske kvinner.
Ja, men hva skjer nå? Vil han bli sittende i ambassaden frem til avhøret?
Ja, det er jo det store spørsmålet. Det er jo ikke akkurat første gangen vi står her og rapporterer om Julian Assange.
Siden 2010 har han vært anklaget for voldtekt og seksuelt overgrep i Sverige.
Det er en anklage om voldtekt og en anklage om seksuelle overgrep.
Assange møtte pressen etter at svensk påtalemyndighet i dag fortalte at de stanser voldtektsetterforskningen av ham. Og da Assange samme høst ble mistenkt for voldtekt i Sverige, nektet han å reise dit for å bli avhørt av frykt for å bli utlevert til USA.
Assange søkte tilflukt i Ecuadors ambassade i London sommeren 2012, for å unngå å bli arrestert og utlevert i Sverige, der han var skyldig for seksuelle overgrep.
Siktet i Sverige for overgrep og voldtekt.
Svenske voldtektsanklager.
I forbindelse med at han var under etterforskning for voldtekt i Sverige.
Men først, Sverige gjenopptar altså voldtektssaken mot Julian Assange. I november 2010 blir han ettersøkt av svenske myndigheter mistenkt for voldtekt av to kvinner.
Special Rapporteur on Torture is warning that WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange is suffering from the effects of psychological torture due to his ongoing detention and threats of possible extradition to the United States. The UN expert, Nils Melzer, also warned Assange would likely face a politicized show trial if he were to be extradited to the United States. Melzer writes, quote, "In 20 years of work with victims of war, violence, and political persecution, I've never seen a group of democratic states ganging up to deliberately isolate, demonize, and abuse a single individual for such a long time." Melzer spoke to reporters this morning in Geneva, Switzerland.
And our finding was that Mr. Assange shows all the symptoms of a person who has been exposed to psychological torture. Mr. Assange was not given the opportunity to defend himself properly in public against allegations of sexual offense without at the same time having to expose himself to a possible extradition to the United States, which obviously is not related to the sexual offenses. But he was not given the opportunity to do so. So for 10 years, his reputation and credibility and his human dignity have been gravely affected by these allegations, and the Swedish prosecution deliberately prevented him from actually taking an official position against that. Now, in the UK courts, we have seen a similar type of bias. He was, the same day he was dragged out of the embassy after more than 6 years, and the same day he was pulled into a UK court. He was given reportedly less than 15 minutes with his defense lawyer to prepare a defense, and then in a very short hearing was convicted for bail violation, and the judge even insulted him as being a narcissist who cannot get beyond himself. Now, as a lawyer, having worked at court myself, I cannot imagine how a judge could come to such a conclusion when the defendant didn't say anything else in that hearing than, "I plead not guilty." So I believe we have to take a step back and look at all these proceedings, how they have been conducted, and come to our own conclusions whether these are fair. We also have to take a step back and look at this whole narrative of suspected rapist, narcissist, selfish, ungrateful person, hacker, and scratch the surface a little bit and see what's below there. When I was first approached by his defense team to seeking protection from my mandate in December last year, I was reluctant to do so because me too, I had been affected by this prejudice that I had absorbed through all these public, you know, narratives spread in the media over the years. And only when I scratched the surface a little bit, I saw how little foundation there was to back this up and how much fabrication and manipulation there is in this case.
WikiLeaks grunnlegger Julian Assange er blitt utsatt for langvarig psykologisk tortur. Det mener FNs spesialrapportør mot tortur, som har besøkt Assange i fengselet i England, der han soner en dom på 50 uker.
What we're speaking about is severe stress and constant stress, a chronic anxiety, severe psychological trauma.
Den svenske klimaaktivisten Greta Thunberg WikiLeaks-grunnlegger Julian Assange blir ikke begjært utlevert til Sverige, i hvert fall ikke ennå. Tingretten i Uppsala har nemlig bestemt at Assange ikke vil bli varetektsfengslet i Sverige, men siktelsen for voldtekt opprettholdes.
Sverige har påtalemyndigheten henlagt voldtektssaken mot WikiLeaks-grunnlegger Julian Assange. Det kom frem på en pressekonferanse i dag. De legger den bort fordi de ikke har tilstrekkelig bevis for at Assange er skyldig. Assange har vært siktet for seksuelle overgrep mot en kvinne i Sverige siden 2010. Sukkerforbruket stuper i Norge. Det kommer frem i en rapport om kostholdet her i landet som helsedirektoratet.
Akkurat første gang vi står her og rapporterer om Julian Assange.
Thank you.
So I'm not sure how many people here are familiar with the basics of my work, and I'll just try and go very briefly through that so you can understand where I'm coming from. As a journalist and as a programmer and as someone who was involved in the embryonic internet and bringing the internet to people and bringing that great tool of information and publishing freedom to people, I saw that we could achieve a lot of reform with a little bit of work. And of course, you all know this, and you should remember Solzhenitsyn's words that in the right moment, one word of truth outweighs the world. And Solzhenitsyn was referring to a world of lies. But this still is true for information across the world, and it's also true for information in the West, that in some cases, one classified video can possibly stop a war, and maybe 50 definitely can. So we tried to pull together a system to automate that process, to get as much new material, censored material, restricted material, material that we thought would achieve political reform, into the historic record and keep it there. He who controls the present controls the past. He who controls internet servers controls the intellectual record of mankind, and by controlling that, controls our perceptions of who we are, and by controlling that, controls what laws and regulations we make in society. So the specific example that I'd like to give, and there are many, many hundreds of these, and no doubt most of you are not aware of them, is a litigious billionaire by the name of Nahadimi Auchi, the fifth richest man in the UK at one stage, whose birthday painting was signed by 146 members of the House of Commons. A very well-connected man, connected politically, connected in business, and connected in the social establishment of the UK. He attempted to remove, through legal threats, articles about his conviction for corruption in France in 2003, in the Elf Aquitaine scandal. And he just sent legal threats. He never went to court. And The Guardian removed four articles about that case from its records. They were over 5 years old, and it never told its readers. They're removed from the index. If you follow links to them, you'll just see page not found. And so did The Times, and so did the London Independent. And so did major internet companies in the United States. But that's just one example of a litigious billionaire, and there are hundreds. In the UK right now, there are 300 secret gag orders. Those are gag orders that not only prevent the press from reporting corruption and abuse, they prevent the press from reporting that the press has been gagged. This is not the liberal democracy that we had all dreamed of. This is an encroaching, privatized censorship regime. And just like everything else in the West that becomes privatized and fiscalized, censorship also is not only a mechanism that is implied by the state. It is something that can be hijacked by wealthy plutocrats, by big companies, to use the coercive mechanisms of the state through the judicial system, through unequal access to the judicial system, through patronage networks, to have material removed permanently from the historical record. So in the West, and we are, after all, in Norway, we should not be too proud about our sense that there is no state censorship, because we have privatized state censorship. We have made it more complex and not as obvious. It is not a brute hammer anymore. It is a sophisticated device, like money laundering through Caribbean tax shelters is a sophisticated device where the brutality is hidden in its complexity. Similarly, when we see the path that countries like the United States, which once had a proud tradition of freedom of the press, is going down, we have to question whether it is really holding those values anymore and what we should do about it. Because if we don't have Western countries as a beacon on the hill for Enlightenment values, what countries are left to hold that value?